You ever visit a website and just immediately hit the back button? Like maybe the page takes forever to load, or maybe it has really bad graphics, or maybe it's way too cluttered. But whatever it is, you just immediately say, I'm a head out. Now imagine people doing that when they visit your company's website. Not what you want, right? But if you aren't using good web design practices, that's just what could be happening. If I made you worry that your web design is filled with problems, it's okay. We're going to walk through some of the most common web design issues that businesses have. If you make sure you're good to go on each of these things, your site should have a solid foundation. Before we go on, just a reminder to subscribe to our YouTube channel. With that out of the way, let's look at 7 common web design mistakes you should avoid. 1. Using poor branding. One of the first mistakes you can make is not properly branding your website. Basically, your website needs to reflect the way you want to present your company's brand. Do you want your brand to be fun? Design your website in a way that feels fun. Do you want to seem prestigious? Make your website look that way. You can do that with different things. Color scheme is one example. If your company has a particular set of colors you use in your branding, you should make those the main colors that you use on your site. You can also do it through things like your font choice. If you built your brand around elegance and high status, you don't want to use, say, Wingdings as your font choice. Actually, you should probably never use Wingdings as your font choice. Anyway, the point is that users will associate your business with what they experience on your site. So that site should be a good representation of your brand. Even if your site looks good, that doesn't matter if it feels like a different company. 2. Not making your site mobile friendly. Another big problem a lot of websites have is that they aren't mobile friendly. The way to fix that problem is to use responsive design on your website. That's a type of web design where the site automatically restructures itself to fit whatever screen is viewed on. So it'll look slightly different on a laptop computer than it will on a phone. By the way, even if you say, well, I don't care about mobile traffic, Google still indexes and ranks websites with a focus on their mobile versions. So if your site is desktop, but not mobile friendly, you'll likely have some trouble ranking above others in the search results. 3. Not designing with SEO in mind. One crucial step in building a website is to use search engine optimization, or SEO. That's where you optimize your site to rank high in Google search results so people can actually find it. There are a couple of SEO tactics you should focus on. Firstly, you should aim for fast page load speeds. If your site takes too long to load, people will just leave. Thankfully, you can improve your page speed first and foremost by compressing images and other multimedia elements. And from a more technical standpoint, you can do things like caching your web pages, limiting redirects, and minifying code. Another important, yet still technical SEO tactic is to avoid having an unsecure website. That's unsecure, not insecure. Although if your site keeps giving you pop-ups asking, "Are you mad at me?" you might want to get that looked at too. When we talk about an unsecure website, we mainly mean a website that doesn't use HTTPS. HTTPS is an alternative to the regular HTTP protocol. It keeps people from being able to hack into your website as easily, so make sure your site uses HTTPS. One last note about SEO. Sometimes sites like to put a cool animation or a welcome screen before the main page content. That might be cool looking, but it's not great for SEO if no one makes it to the main page. So make sure your design isn't creating a bad user experience. 4. Not leaving enough white space. One mistake we see a lot of companies make is thinking that they have to fill up every square inch of their website with something. So what ends up happening is that you visit the site and feel like you're in Times Square. There's a million different things jumping out at you. It's overwhelming. Don't do that on your site. It's just going to make people leave. Instead, make good use of white space, that is, the empty space between text and graphics. You don't want to stick images everywhere they'll fit, and you also don't want huge paragraphs of text. Give the site room to breathe. You should also try to use visual design to direct people's eyes to the most important parts of the page. You don't want them to be unsure about where they're supposed to look. 5. Creating a poor navigation setup. Have you ever been to an amusement park and not been able to find a map? It can sometimes be a nightmare trying to find the rides you want or navigate your way around the park. It's the same way when users visit your website and it doesn't have a good navigation setup. They'll get lost, frustrated, and eventually just leave. To keep them from doing that, you gotta make it easy for them to find their way around. The best way to do that is to put a navigation bar at the top of the page that shows all the different sections of the website. You can also use breadcrumb navigation, which looks like this. It shows you where you are on the website at any given time. 6. Not using enough visual media. Okay, let's pause for just a second. Remember when I said earlier that you don't want to stuff every square inch of your site with visual elements? That's still true, but having said that, you do still want to use visual media. If all you have is text, users will get bored. You want to make sure you break up your text with occasional images and graphics when you can. That visual aspect will help keep people's attention. You can also use videos, which are awesome at keeping people engaged. I mean, I've been talking for several minutes, but you're still watching. Now imagine if all this info was just a giant wall of text. A lot less interesting, right? But in a video format, anything can happen. 7. Using outdated design or content. Finally, it's important to make sure you're not using outdated material on your website. That starts with content. For example, you don't want a video from 2011 up on your site that refers to Instagram as the newest social media platform. You also don't want the design of your site to look outdated. Web design has definitely changed a lot over the decades, so if your website still looks the same way as it did in 2004, you might want to update your look. Otherwise, the only user that'll be interested in your site is your local museum. Well, that's it for today's video. Don't leave just yet, though. There are plenty of other cool videos on this channel. If you find them helpful, be sure to subscribe. You can also subscribe to our email newsletter, Revenue Weekly, over on our website. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.